Tatiana.
Sit down,
get up, little mama.
Sit down,
bust down, Tatiana. And give it to me, little mama. Hey.
Hi guys, it's your girl Tati Tat, Tatiana or Tati, or whatever you wanna call me, and welcome, welcome back to my channel. And if you're new here, or if this is the first time you see my face, yes, my lovely face like that, you can hit that subscribe button or turn on that post notification bell so you can become part of the Tati family. It's only fun and vibes over here. Alright? Alright. Now, in today's video, I'm going to be doing a part 2 to my back to school series, right? And in this video, I'm going to be talking about Form 6. So like my Form 6 experience and tips that I have for people that let this ambulance pass, or this police, whatever it is, let it pass. Right, so basically I'm going to be talking about my Form 6 experience, things I learned in Form 6, and some tips I would like to share with people who want to do Form 6 or in Unit 1 going in Unit 2, right? I get this video idea from Seychelle. I get this video idea from her, so I will put her video up here and down in the description box below. I also get it from Brahmin. I hope I'm saying his name correctly. Now I will put his video down in the description below as well, so you can check them out after you done watch my thing. You understand? So I finished Form 6. I done Form 6. I finished Form 6 last year. It wasn't even September, because last year was the whole beginning of this whole Miss Rona. So I think like when I get my results from Frocky, I can't even remember, but it wasn't in September. But yeah, so I do CAPE last year, July, August, because that when CAPE was last year, right? So I just tell all you my experience and why I went through in Form 6, right? I didn't do Form 6 in my original secondary school. I didn't leave my secondary school, and I do Form 6 in sixth form government school, right? So the school I went to, it only had upper 6 and lower 6. That is the only two forms it had in the whole school. I personally leave the school, my original secondary school, because I wanted a new experience. I wanted to be around new people. I wanted to experience like a new feel of things now. So that way I didn't go back to my original secondary school. I leave that school and went to a new one, right? One thing I want to say, if you're doing Form 6, do Form 6 because you want to do Form 6. Don't do it because your friend doing it or whatever. Make sure that's what you want to do. So the first thing I would like to cover, or the first topic I want to say, is ask yourself why you want to do Form 6, or if you have to do Form 6, right? Because a lot of people that say you don't have to do Form 6, it's not worth it, it's a waste of time, it's too hard, it's hard. But but ask yourself why you want to do it, right? Some people just do Form 6 because they need to do it to get into a specific university, or they need to do it because of the career path they want to take in life, or they're doing it because they simply just don't know where else they want to do in their life right now. They're not finished secondary school, you're not finished CSEC, you're lost, you're confused, you don't know if you want to be a doctor, a lawyer, a teacher, accountant, you don't know what you want to do, right? So some people just do Form 6 to figure out like what they want to do with for the rest of their life, for their career path, right? That was me. When I finished Form 5, I didn't know what I wanted to do after. Like, I was stuck. So what I do, I take a week off after I get my results. I take a week off to cool myself, to cool my brains, and figure out what I want to do. And then I figure out, well, right, I will do Form 6 and try to figure it out from there. And while I was in Form 6, I did figure out what I want to do for the rest of my life, right? What I want to be, what career path I want to go on, right? My second thing is, before you pick your subjects to do Form 6 that you're doing in Form 6, I would advise you to please do research on the subjects before you pick it, because I do only business subjects in Form 6. first C, second form, five. I do languages. I was in the languages class in form five. That is English A, English B, you know, them kind of thing. Spanish, them kind of thing. And I switched from languages and I make a big jump to only business subjects. I did not do any research on any of the subjects I picked to do in form six. Love that. So you can imagine me, a girl who never do accounting. When I see management or business and it had accounting, I was catching my tail. So please do research on the top, the subjects you'd want to do in Form 6 before you pick it. And know if you're willing to learn something new. Know if you're willing to learn something new or you just want to further the subjects you're doing Form 5. Now, oh, you're just fighting out there, girl. I honestly didn't know Form 6 was so much a work. I know it was work because I used to talk to people in Form 6 when I was in Form 4 and 5. I used to say, girl, it's real work, it's real work. But I didn't know it was so much. You understand? Because people just think, because in Form 6 you just do four subjects, right? You just do your three subjects you pick, and a compulsory subject, which is either Caribbean studies or communication studies, right? So four subjects you just do for Form 6. People just think because it's less subjects is less work. No lover, baby, each subject has three modules. And you have to, a module real long. I didn't even know what a module was until I reached Form 6. You understand? You have to learn all these modules. I think I'm saying that wrong. I have a title. But you have to learn all these things. Four subjects. Three modules for each subject. And a module is long. Tick. According to the subject you're doing. You understand? You have to learn all this for Kate. So just expect a heavy work load in Form 6. The next thing in Form 6 is that a lot of teachers don't spoon feed you. Like in Form 5, that a teacher will come on the board and write down everything for your notes. Unless you're doing maths lover or Spanish, or that's all I can say. Unless you're doing maths, physics, Spanish, something that you need a lot of notes for, a lot of times teachers might write the complete notes on the board, love. They don't spoon feed you. You have a book, your book had the information in it. Learn. Learn. So I will suggest finding a technique that you know that works for you, that you can learn a certain way, right? If you don't understand something in class, ask a question. Don't sit down there quiet because nobody is. Let me tell you something. In Form 6, people go fool all you. People go sit down when the teacher asks if you understand, and the whole class say yes miss or yes sir. I am telling you, 99.9% of the time, half of the class don't know what's going on. But nobody don't want to ask a question. Raise your hand, but we in Zoom right now. Raise your hand in the damn Zoom call. Say, miss, I don't understand. You can repeat, please. Because 9 out of 10 times, half the class don't know what's going on. Ask a question. Don't stay silent for me. Please, in unit 1 or lower 6, try your best in every subject for me, please, because people had the mentality, and I see that a lot when I was in Form 6, that when you're in lower you can do whatever you want. You'll do whatever you want, your line, your this, your that, your whatever. You can lie, you know, you can lie because you're only human, but you can play the fool in lower 6. Get 4s, 5s, even though I think 4 or 5 is a passing kid. You could get 4 or 5 in lower six, and when they reach upper six, you could get your ones and twos. Try your best in form six, in lower six for me, please. Try your best in unit one for me, please. Because to play catch up in unit two, it's not going to be nice. Find out about your IAs as soon as possible. And for people, if you're now doing form six, I don't know what IA is. IA is an internal assessment. You understand? It's like SBAs, but a little harder. Right? A little more work. Right? Find out about your IAs as soon as possible. Find out your mark, how much marks and how much percentage your IAs is carrying for your specific subject. Right? Find out if the subject that you are doing, if it needs a unit 1 and a unit 2 IA. Yes, you have to do some subjects, you have to do 2 IAs. For unit 1, IA for unit 1 and IA for unit 2. Find out if the subjects that you are doing has 2 IAs, right? I can tell you for a fact, entrepreneurship has 2 IAs. Unit 1 and unit 2. That was the only subject I did that needed 2 IAs. The rest of my business subject, 1 IA. So try your best to get a high mark in your IA in unit 1. Because I know you wouldn't want to do over your IA in unit 2. You have to learn how to manage your time. Because when I didn't know start form 6, I cried. Because I felt like I only had time for work, for school work, right through. I didn't join no extracurricular activities until like the 3rd or 4th week in form 6. Other than that, the first 2 weeks, I was just feeling like it's only work. I had no time for nothing, right? Learn to manage your time in form 6. Please, because assignments just be coming back to back. IAs just be hitting you back to back. Make time for yourself, but learn how to manage your time at the same time. It will be difficult, but you have to learn time management when you're in form 6. I said it in my last video for advice for form 4 and 5, and I'll say it in this video again. Pass papers is your best friend in form 6. Pass papers is your best friend. Them paper 1 and them paper 2, you better marry it. Every time you do a topic, try to get a pass paper on it for me, please. Pass papers is your best friend. That is the key to pass papers. As often as you can, do a pass paper for me. Please do a pass paper as often as you can. Form 6 has a lot of distractions. Because he is a senior student. He has done a half a man, a half a woman already. You are a senior student. Teachers don't really be around you. They don't dwell on you. They don't take you on when you're in form 6. Because in them eyes, you done big already. You just here for the next 2 years to get them extra key passes. But have some kind of discipline in form 6, because you'd have real distractions in form 6. People go one line, real back and all, real this, real that, and real people have the mentality when they reach form 6, they reach form 6, that, you know, boom, all they have to do now is escape and they're done. Try to focus on your work and stay away from distractions for me, please. Last thing I want to talk about, the second to last thing I want to talk about is form 6 could take a toll on your mental health. It can. You can become stressed. It can become depressed with the amount of workload, the amount of work you could. It have guidance counselors. Every school has one. Plenty people doesn't want to go by the guidance counselor. But baby, I'm telling you, when you're feeling stressed and forms you're starting to take a toll on your mental and you will cry. I being real honest with all you. You will cry, you will feel stressed. Your mental health might start to go down a little bit. Talk to your guidance counselor for me. Please, once you have one, talk to one. The most important thing, pray. Pray and talk to God as much as you can. In either in form 5, in form 6, in upper 6, in lower 6, in university. Talk to God as much as you can. Because all things is possible through Him. You understand? God is with her. She will not fail. That was my whole quote from form 5 up to present. But thank you all for watching this video. I hope all you did enjoy it. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe for more videos. Right? Part 3 of my back to school series will be coming out, if not next week, the following week. Right? I hope all you like it. Leave a comment down below. You know? So see all you in my next video.
My
bye.
Life for some of them don't know about work. So hard, me still about some, me don't know. But that don't mean me have to slow down. Cut through the pain, the little fit, but also all out.